Course, another open world single RPG game I have to play it. You know me. What's up, my boys and girls? Inglorious Nets here, your boy, your lovely boy George. How I couldn't make a review about this weird, but of course, extremely beautiful and amazing game. So, words at words, if you haven't played already this game, just take my advices, and if you have already played, just enjoy our company. Let's dive in a world full of ancient martial arts and a huge biodome. Biomutant is developed by Swedish developer Experiment 101 and published by THQ Nordic. It was released on 25 May 2021 for PC, PS4, PS5 and Xbox Series. It is an amazing single-player action RPG set in a weird post-apocalyptic world to discover and travel through your walkthrough. And yes, tiny mammals have become martial art masters. Your main character is separated between a guinea pig and a cat or something like that. This weird-looking mutant character decides to save the Earth as it is in a great danger once again. In addition, Biomutant, except from the gorgeous landscapes and cities giving to you in order to explore them, it also offers you great combats. As you go through the game, you have the ability to unlock many customizable weapons and a huge variety of kicks and slices. Despite all that, I found a little weird and difficult all these combos of combat, especially while playing with keyboard and mouse. At least, it has not lack of many objectives, side quests, puzzles and of course, a very well-made storyline, which personally I was amazed by. As I have said in previous reviews, such as in Valheim and Ghost of Tsushima, I am in love with the well-made landscapes. I am a person which I believe that you can actually judge a game from this. I spend many hours in every open world game I play, exploring the maps and enjoying every single view. Fortunately, Biomutant is one of these games. It is really a shame the missions and objectives feel stale after some hours, because the world, the post-apocalyptic world, or if you want biodome, is very impressive. That's a great sense of grand scale, specifically things like the main tree of life and landmarks like collapsing bridges or destroyed cities. Of course, there is also a variety of thick forest to scorching desert, radioactive zones and barren wastelands. The most interesting thing in exploring the map is that these places are filled with enemies with an extremely fantastic character design, and there are so many different types of creatures or mutant animals to battle. I have spent many hours in the game and still I am encountering new enemies I had never seen before. They are not particularly smart and you may fight them even trapped in rooms, but the range of them is enormous. Another thing I liked a lot in the game is the first several hours, even though they are enough boring for being the start of a game like that. As you click in the new game, you are forced to get through a very clever system, which is a bit like a genetic dartboard, automatically adjusting your hero's appearance depending on what core stats you want to bolster before diving in. Additionally, there are a bunch of available character classes that will define your avatar initial appearance. You can be whoever you want, from a samurai mercenary to a commando with a huge blade and guns. The last but very important was the choice you have to do between your aura. You can either go with loyalty and faith as a light aura, or you can listen to your dark side of your inner and choose a black aura, which gives you power and strength. Is it an open world RPG game? If so, crafting materials, upgrading your arms and weapons cannot be missing from the game. Even though collecting materials is a bit difficult and after some hours drives to be a little boring, you have to go all that. As you are leveling up, your enemies start being stronger and stronger. Modify and craft your weapons and armors, checking stats between them and managing your materials are some of them you are going to meet even from the start. Of course, if there are many types of creatures and mutant animals for you to fight, there is also an impressive range of choices for battling them. Biomutant has a huge variety of different styles and options, so many that you feel you will not gonna use all of them even if you spend an enormous amount of hours on the game. Personally, for most of my campaign I was supported by my 200mm weapon, a heavily upgraded automatic rifle and a couple of powers I had found useful in my playstyle, including in this levitation, a ground pound that spews out toxic waste and a supernatural dust which can kick you out. I am sure you will love all the powers as you can choose everything you want, from ice powers to bouncy mutant mushrooms and extremely fast fire dashes. All this gonna get you out of danger when necessary, definitely when you are battling a bunch of enemies. Ending for the combat system, I would like to remind you what I said in the start. Even if you are a player with keyboard and a mouse, I would suggest you to play it on control. Yes, smashing a simple button is sufficient to a point, but to execute cool combos is required good skills and it is a bit difficult. However, when you start getting used to it, all these combos will be a lot of entertaining and of course useful against every new creature you are going to discover. Everything about Biomutant is a bit weird, so why the story is going to be delivered normal? Beyond what seems to be good and evil, halves of your character's conscience, all of the dialogue is delivered by a single narrator.
He made a suction device, so the Mecton can...
who explains every new area, discover, translate NPC's dialogue, and he keeps you company in logged instances. Of course, I found it extremely amazing, as it helps you feel like you are in a fairy tale, but in some points it seems to be a bit annoying. The narrator himself also swings drastically his mood, as one minute he starts talking philosophical words about the ever-branching and beautiful ramifications of Tree of Life, and the next he's explaining all of my moves and hits with words like bang, poof, and pong. Personally, I liked it a lot, even though before playing the game I had heard complaints about this. If you play it, I would like you to comment down below what you think for it. After these incredible first hours, you start a great storyline. Biomutant specifically seems to spin its wheel a bit. You are forced to choose a tribe to ally which locks you into certain goals, uniting or conquering the tribes, and either you save the Tree of Life or letting it die. Either way, the enemy base conquest mission 3 quickly unfurls to reveal that it's largely just a series of repeated sequences and recycled divinities. Unfortunately, there is no real flexibility when it comes to conquering outposts, cause strange invisible walls will stop you if you try to sneak from a different angle. You can only tackle them via a rigid series of encounters, repeated from tribe to tribe and base to base, whether you are trying to unite the tribes or conquer the whole world. Now, personally, I try to work for a peaceful tribe whose leader wanting me to save the Tree of Life and destroy the World Eaters. There are 4 World Eaters in the whole map, and they consider to be the most difficult bosses to defeat in the game. These boss fights are identical whether you are trying to stop them eating the Tree of Life or you are trying to let them eat. Of course, another thing I found extremely attractive was the preparation which you need to do in order to fight specifically these bosses. This keeps you really focused and addicted to the game, as you have to gather a bunch of parts for a vehicle and catch 5 little creatures that you'll later be able to launch at these bosses as distractions. Of course, after some hours spending of collecting stuff and collecting stuff, it may take you in a very boring campaign. Finally, yes, Biomutant is a great game and probably one of the best open world games I have ever played. It has excellent creatures design, amazing landscapes and places to discover and explore, a huge variety of combos, skills, powers, weapons and customizations when it comes to combat, and of course, an amazing storyline with many missions, side quests and objectives to spend hours and hours. Has some negatives, but personally I don't care about them as they didn't annoy my gameplay. Welcome to Biomutant, a post-apocalyptic world. Here lies ancient martial arts which wait for you to manipulate them. Alright, my family, that was my review about Biomutant. I truly hope you enjoyed our video and helped you to understand more about Biomutant, or even if you made the choice to go and buy it. Of course, if you really liked it, please smash the like button so many people can see our content and our work. Also, if you are not one of us, you should really join us by smashing the subscriber button and being an inglorious nerd. Finally, as in every review, we would like to see your comments down below so that we are able to know if our work is helpful for you. That was for me. Unfortunately, we say goodbye, but of course, only until the next video. Stay safe, stay strong, and keep up the good work.